innovator. Bakit yan ang innovator? Because I'm into sustainability and innovation. That's why I call myself, ako lang yung pangalan sa sarili ko actually, Chief Greenovator of Everything Green Trading and Consulting. So I'm also the entrepreneur in residence, as mentioned earlier, at De La Salle College of St. Benil, hub for innovation, hub of innovation for inclusion. It's actually a technology business incubator wherein we incubate startups, but mostly on the creatives. Since we are a creative school, our main banner program would be into design and digital interactive. Okay, I also came from a big family. Ayan, lagi ko itong sinishare. Kasi it's good for that you should also be self-aware kung saan kayo. Because bilang isang entrepreneur or isang MSME, dapat importante na alam niya yung roots na, di ba? Because that would also show with your individuality and as a founder, it would also reflect who you are. So yun, I came from a big family. On the lower photo, that's actually a photo taken in 2002. Tapos sa itaas ko is taken in 2019 during my mother's 80th birthday. So if you've noticed, may napansin ba kayo? May napansin ba? Ang mga tagal Valenzuela. May napansin ba kayo? Ayan. If you've noticed, we're actually wearing the same clothes. Diba? So talaga, sabi ko nga eh, hindi ko alam na into sustainable fashion ako. Kumbaga, when it comes to wearables, we're talking about wearables, diba? So I didn't even know that we're already practicing sustainability. Because meron tayong sort of culture bilang isang Pilipino, diba? That we don't really throw away right away yung mga gamit natin. And tingnan nyo to, 2002, then job 2019, ilang years yun, yung magaling sa math. But because of that, nare-realize mo na, oo nga no, we always keep our clothes. Kung kaya natin huwag itapon, isi-save up pa natin. And ibig sabihin, yung mom ko, since siya yung fashionista, 80 na siya dito, di ba? So, I think it's good that she has also inculcated or exemplified that trait. And I'm sure sa lahat sa atin, kung ano yung tinuro sa atin ng magulang natin, yung values nila is actually part of our identity and is also part of what who we are in terms of how we run our business. Or bilang isang founder, bilang isang entrepreneur, ganun din. So kaya pala, nagkaroon ako ng interest sa sustainable fashion. I am also a proud wife, as the saying goes, happy wife equals happy life, di ba? Because bilang isang MSME founder, it's also good that we have a strong support system. Anyway, di ba? So, importante, kasi siya yung aking angel investor. Financier, kapitalista. Di ba? So, kailangan may ganyan tayo palagi sa ating mga negosyo. Dapat meron tayong support system in different ways. Okay? Ayan na. Hindi na kumanda ulit. Namatay ba? Ang tech. Parang nalungka yun. I'm also a fur mom to 5 babies. Ang cute nila, di ba? So, hindi yung dahilan kung bakit ako nagtatrabaho. Kasi mas magastos pa sila kaysa sa mas magastos pa yung food nila lahat sa atin, di ba? Anyway, tapos, fun fact, I grew up po sa Africa, Lagos, Nigeria. Nung pagulang ko po ay nagtrabaho bilang OFW sa Africa. And dati ako, Miss Philippines! Kasi ako lang naman yung Pilipino, ako lang naman yung pila doon. So, pero sabi ko nga, one day, pinangarap ko talaga, hindi po maging Miss Universe ha, hindi ko pinangarap maging Miss Universe o Pilipinas. Gusto pa nangarap ko talaga na sana one day, yung mga produkto natin dito sa Pilipinas ay maidala po sa ibang bansa. At ma-representa ang Pilipinas sa mga talents, skills, products that we have. So, yeah. So, yan po ako. And, hindi ko alam kung saan ako magpo-point. Dito po. May nakaharang ka rin? Ayun. And while I was, na-mention din po, while I was in the hospitality industry for, actually hindi yan 15 years, 20 years, na-realize ko that the hospitality industry, marami siya talagang waste na napoproduce. So sabi ko, I have to do something about it. So, tapos doon ko na-realize kung ano talaga yung purpose ko. So ngayon, tanungin ko din kayo later on, bilang isang may-ari, isang entrepreneur, ano yung purpose niyo? Yeah. Sabi, siguro nang nagtatanong, anong connection nito sa tech? Anong connection nito sa tech wearable innovation, diba? Actually, marami. Yung mga sinasabi ko, it's actually related to who you are. So talagang importante yung self-awareness. Next na lang po ah. Ayan. And I've also realized that nung nasa hotel ako, that for every time na nag-check-in ang isang guest, nag-accumulate pala siya ng 1 kilo of waste. Right? And then, sabi ko nga, pag in-add-up mo lahat ng mga chinelas na yan sa buong mundo, abot siya ng 27 million pairs. In 1 year. Isipin niyo yun ha. Tapos lahat ng mga slippers na to ay gawa sa polyester. Gawa siya sa plastic. Ibig sabihin, we're adding to the landfill. At saan siya napupunta? Mga ganitong basura. Saan napupunta?
Landfill.
Sa?
Waste.
Sa landfill at saka napupunta din sa dagat. Diba? So, sinong naapektuhan? Tayo, right? We get affected with all the climate change, flood, pag nagbagyo. This is because of our way of doing things. Kumbaga part na to ng lifestyle namin. Sige, Sir Pandana. So while I was in the hospitality industry, sabi ko, kung kaya pala ng ibang bansa na magkaroon ng sustainable hotel slippers, bakit hindi natin kaya? So naghanap ako, tapos na-realize ko na sa Bicol at saka sa Quezon, marami pala tayong agricultural waste. At yung agricultural waste na to ay para pwede natin gamitin to become a sustainable product. So, ayun. So this is actually our first meeting in 2018 with our partner community in Visitan, Labo, Camarines Norte. They are actually part of the community-based forest management. Alam ko marami tayo nakikita mga products dyan, mga MSMEs din na who uses mga natural materials. And then, that is why Grinelas was born. We are the first ever greener alternative hotel slippers na proudly Filipino-made. And kami din po yung slippers na makikita nyo sa mga 5-star hotels na community-based. Kasi that's what we do. We bridge from the community, we bridge our products, the agricultural waste, by helping also different sectors. So, yung mission talaga namin is really to create eco-solutions and innovative products through empowered Filipino craftsmanship and expertise para to help industries to become more sustainable. But not only in the hotel, in gusto natin in all sectors. But of course, since hotelier ako, love your own sector and be able to really contribute. Okay, next slide. So how do we do this? Sino na familiar dito with circular business model? Familiar ba kayo? Circularity. Yan ang mga buzzword ngayon. Aside from sustainability, we also have circular business models. Di ba sabi ko kanina, we're not just helping our artisans, but we're also helping the farmers. From farmers, up to the community na nagpa-process ng waste, up to the artisans na nag-renovate, and then also educate the hotels and organizations up to the guests on how to compose the materials or the slippers para we can actually create a circular business model. So, sa tingin niyo ba, innovation ba ito o hindi? When you say innovation, yeah. Because when you say technology, it doesn't mean na laging software, di ba? Hindi laging apps, hindi lahat. When you say technology, is that you are actually introducing an innovation when it comes to solving a problem. So, yun pang innovation. Sino po dito into wearables, non-food, ayan, si ma'am, di ba? And then, yeah, look at it. So, look at this into, na pwede pala natin gawin na pwede rin pala siya maging 100% compostable. That's actually the one, that's our goal. As of today, I cannot claim na fully compostable siya because meron pa rin tayong ginagamit na thread, adhesive. But the adhesive now is, we're developing a new formulation actually that would involve natural adhesive without using all the chemicals para talagang masasabi natin gawang Pinoy na first in the Philippines. So please watch out for that innovation. Okay, next slide. So these are the communities. Sino po mga partner communities natin? Mga kababaihan. Kaya I believe in empowering women. I also believe in empowering those who are like also mga persons with disability. We also have a deaf community in Quezon City. So sila po yung mga makers. So you could just imagine, no? Yung mga ganitong produkto na dadala pala siya sa 5-star hotels. Yun. So this is part of the innovation that we teach. We share the knowledge that we have. Because importante din po yung tinatawag natin na tech transfer. Yung technology or innovation transfer. Because we also have to teach yung mga community members natin on how to do this. Okay, next slide, sir. Ayan. And diba sabi ko nga, since mahilig ako sa animals, I feel, ano, actually I feel sad whenever I see plastic na nasa dagat. Kasi, in fact, there is even a study that tayo pala, pag kumakain tayo ng fish, meron na palang microplastics tayo na po-consume as humans. So, ito, it's part of the innovation that we want, that we want to support, of course, our local MSMEs. We want to support MSMEs that has sustainable practices. And also, kung hindi man nakakapag-eliminate ng plastic right away, yung proper disposal. Okay, next slide. So, aside from that, we also had a runway, a virtual runway, through the support of the British Council. And at the height of the pandemic, this was in 2020 and 2021, we were very blessed to be part of the cultural exchange program of the British Council. And yung mga materials na ginagamit namin in terms of wearables, yan, pili nutshells. Parang alam ko meron yata din dito sa mga MSMEs. Using pili nutshells, abaka, water lily, banana. So lahat na to, ng mga pwede tinatapon na, minidisregard, actually, pwede pang magamit for fashion, for innovation, and for technology. Okay, next slide. Ayan po. And we also partner with various, hindi lang po sa hotel, but yung mga ibang nail salon, for instance. So sabi ko nga, yung partnership pala with these organizations or mga corporations, because they also value the same values that we have. So ang tip ko, actually one of the best practices, is to look for that partner who you think you align with in terms of your values. Ayun, I'll repeat that. You look